American Crate All-Star Late Models. You guys are after this feature, so you should already be starting to get ready. American Crate All-Stars, you are after the Modified Street 20 lap feature, so you need to start getting ready and getting close to being staged up soon. All right, folks, here we go. Modified Street's got the one to go from Hollywood on the flag stand. Ready to see 20 lap action from these guys. David Clark and Wayne Rader are going to lead off the pack. Both of them qualify with a 14.7, as well as Caleb Trent and Lance Kreisman. So the first two rows, first four cars, separated by a tenth of a second qualifying. Okay, delayed yellow, so now we're getting the one to go from Hollywood. So again, these first four cars were only delayed, or only difference between them in qualifying by a tenth of a second. So watch out. These front four cars are all evenly paced. Let's see what the changes in the track, which of the cars, which of the drivers are going to adjust to it the best. We saw some of the drivers in the heat race late models. Josh Henry, definitely of note, who won his heat race, ran the bottom of the track. So bottom of the track may be coming in for some of these guys. Let's see if any of these modified streets have it. Here we go. Hollywood's ready to put the green flag up. David Clark's going to put the loud pedal down. We're going racing 20 laps. David Clark with the early move up. Wayne Rader going to cross over and get underneath him, and they're going to go side by side down the back stretch. Wayne Rader still running the bottom. David Clark running the top. Going to run all the way down the cushion. Clark barely crossing the line as your leader in lap one. Lance Kreisman challenging Caleb Trent on the inside of the second row. Wayne Rader again going to dive it down, going to slide up. David Clark maybe got a little bit loose up into the loose stuff there. Didn't quite ride the cushion around, and Wayne Rader will take lap number two. Lance Kreisman way off the pace. Something happened to him. Caleb Trent and the 21H of Tyler Haynes move up. Wayne Rader with a four-car lead over David Clark now, as Caleb Trent is off the power and way up high on the racetrack. Not sure what happened to him. He's back under power now, but he really just completely left off the throttle there. And again, he's off the power. Something wrong with the three machine of Caleb Trent. And he is stalled out in turn four. That will pull out of caution. He could not get off the racetrack. I think he was looking to dive down. I think Caleb was looking to dive down. He does have a little bit of right rear damage there, so I didn't see him hit the wall, but definitely some right rear damage on Caleb Trent's three machine. Is he going to pull all the way into the pits? Yes, he will. He's not even getting a look from the officials, so he's actually going to pull it all the way in and let his pit crew take a look. Maybe not. Okay, no, it looks like Caleb's crew is pushing his car, so not a good sign for him. But Wayne Rader with our Delaware restart. And then David Clark chose the bottom line, and we are going to restart here with Tyler Haynes moving from seventh all the way up to third now. Big mover from him. Wayne gets us going around turns one and two. Tyler Haynes with a great run off of turns one and two. He's going to challenge Wayne for the lead, but does fall right in line. And now looking on the inside of Wayne, gets a little bit sideways, loses some momentum. Wayne Rader just going to take off and leave the field now as Haynes, Clark, Kreisman, and Steele round out your top five. Wayne Rader just holding a very steady, smooth middle of the track line. Rest of the field seems to be going bottom and top, trying to find something that works, but Wayne Raider's got it dialed in, and he is absolutely walking away with it now. Tyler Haynes putting a little space between him and David Clark, as Clark has Kreisman and Steele now creeping up on his rear. Oh no, looks like Kreisman's off the power in turns one and two, and he will dive into the pits, and he will drop out of the race now. Lance Kreisman with some sort of car trouble. Rader, Haynes, Clark, Steele, and we do have a battle for fifth between the 57 of Chad Barrett and the 55 of Logan Preston, who did not qualify, but is doing just fine now as he basically crossed the line together. Oh, we got another car, the B01 of Brandon Johnson off the power in turn four. trying to get to the pits, trying to get out of the way as we are halfway through our 20-lap feature here of Modified Streets. 55 and the 57 still battling out as they go down the backstretch. It's really the only race on the racetrack right now as Wayne Raider's trying to navigate the lap traffic getting around the 7 of Shane Taylor. He will successfully do so. And again, the only two cars battling for position right now are the 55 of Logan Preston and the 57 of Chad Barrett. Wayne Raider starting to maybe see Shane, see Tyler Haynes behind him. And I don't know if maybe his spotters let him know that maybe Haynes is starting to make up some ground, perhaps. I don't know. Wayne's going to have some lap traffic to deal with as he starts to catch up with the 57 and the 55. And we will see if that holds him enough up for Haynes to make a move. So, oh, there we go. See, that's what I was worried about. 57 slides up, and Wayne has to check up, and 57 is just not getting out of Raider's way, and now the 7 car pulling into the pits adds a little more drama to the mix. Well, Raider now has made it through both of the lap cars, and now Haynes is having to navigate his way through, and he does so without any drama. Did make up a couple of car lengths on Raider, though, as Raider is coming up on the S18 of steel lap traffic. I do believe that's going to be the only way that Haynes has a chance of catching Radar. Radar is absolutely on rails going around the S18 of Landon Steele and has open air in front of him with only 2 to go. Haynes also gets around the lap traffic but does not have enough time without something dramatic happening to Wayne Raider. Then I don't think Tyler Haynes is going to be able to make anything happen here. White flag in the air, final lap. Wayne Raider making his way down turns 3 and 4 for the final time, and he will see the checkers from Hollywood on the flag stand. And your Modified Street feature winner, the 01 of R of Wayne Raider. Second place, the 21H of Tyler Haynes. I believe the third place car was David Clark. All right, so I can't say with any confidence who fourth and fifth were. The scoring system is not available to me at the moment. Having some technical difficulties up here in the booth, but we know Wayne Raider won. We know Tyler Haynes was second. Pretty sure David Clark was third. Those guys will go across the scale, certify their race weight, and we'll send it down to Tiffany for the presentation.
Boys, he was your 2019 Modified Street Champion. He's back in victory lane. We're going to get a word with him real quick. First time in victory lane in 2020 here at the Gap. How do you feel?
I feel great because I ain't nobody been able to beat Clark. I've just been lucky. So I like to thank Jerry Hooks and everybody that comes and watches me. It just feels good.
Anybody we need to thank sponsor-wise for getting it done tonight?
Well, Jerry Hooks, he's the one. It's his car. I'll just drive.
All right. Get Wayne Raider, guys. He is your 2020 first.
Clyde Stanton, let's get that green flag ready to go up and the loud pedal to go down. Clyde Stanton, David Bullington going to take us to the start of 20-lap feature Sportsman Late Model Volunteer Speedway. Here we go. We're underway. Clyde Stanton with a good early start. David falling in quickly behind him. Joe Bray right underneath Bullington for second place. Bray gets up into Bullington to make a little contact, but we have a caution as Josh Detweiler slides all the way down to the bottom of the racetrack in turns 1 and 2. We should go green this time around, though, and we'll keep an eye on that battle. Clyde got a really good start on that first restart. Bullington, a little bit of sleep, and allowed Joe Bray to get underneath him. They made a little contact coming into turn 2. So we'll see if Bullington's got anything for this restart here. A little lesson learned on that. Here we go, coming around. We'll watch for Clyde to start the field up, get him up to speed. Here we go, firing him off out of turn four. Much better restart. David Bullington with a wonderful restart, gets that high groove and will take the lead. Oh, and big damage, big wreck in turn two. All right, Josh Detweiler went into the pits for some service and is back out on the track. So again, full restart here. Try this again. David Bullington with a good restart last time. This time Clyde Stenton fires off a little bit earlier, but Bullington falls right in behind him. It's battle for third between Bray and McMahon. And the 40 car and the 38D spinning it out in turn one and two again. All right, we're getting the one to go from Hollywood. Kyle Manis will have to go to the back of the field because he did come into the pits. But we are ready to get this started. Clyde Stanton and David Bullington on the front row. Joe Bray and Warren McMahon on the second row. Coming around, and Hollywood will warm up that arm and get that green flag waving so we can go 20 laps Sportsman late models again. Or not. Going to try to bring this around again. We'll get this going. All right, Clyde is green and David Bullington is going to fall in line behind him. Joe Bray underneath Bullington for second. They are side by side in turn two. Going down the backstretch, still too wide. Joe Bray going to get the inside edge and take second on his own, followed by Bullington and McMahon. 25K of Kyle Manis running fifth. We got nine cars left from the 14-car starting field here, and we have an official lap on the books now in the Sportsman Late Model feature. Two laps down now. All right, McMahon now diving underneath Bullington, challenging for third. Bullington staying up on the high side, trying to get that momentum. McMahon will slide up in front and take over third position. Clyde Stanton with a comfortable 3-4 car length lead, as Bullington now has Kyle Manis peeking on the inside of him for fourth. Manis not with any sort of momentum to get up there, so Bullington will still hold down fourth position right now, but that is the only battle on the racetrack. Manis and Bullington. McMahon starting to make some ground up on Joe Bray, though, for second. So keep an eye on that 76 and 33 while we also watch the 20 and the 25K battling it out right behind them. Clyde Stanton with the first lap of the 40 car. Joe Bray now running up on the lap traffic as well, followed by McMahon, Bullington, and Manis. Whoa, 40 car up into the outside wall, trying to let the traffic go underneath him. All right, 40 cars now diving down to the bottom of the racetrack, and we got the 28 car off the pace now as well of Richard Cox. I think that's just both lap traffic letting the faster cars by them. Meanwhile, back on the lead lap, Joe Bray has Warren McMahon knocking on his back door, followed by Bullington and Manis, and we do have caution on the racetrack as the 40 car of Buddy Ball is at a stop in turn three. Followed by the 28 of Richard Cox and the 3 car, the C3 of Dylan Cole and Josh Detweiler bringing up the rear. All right, Hollywood's ready to get the green flag waving. Clyde will get us underway. They get the 76 of Joe Bray. Made a little contact with McMahon. Then I'm not quite sure if Bullington pushed him the rest of the way around. But not the cleanest of restarts there as Joe Bray gets pushed around. Line, David Bullington outside of him, followed by Kyle Manis and Dylan Cole. So that's your current top five. Hollywood's ready to wave the green flag once again, and Clyde Stanton will fire off, and here we go. Warren McMahon with a pretty solid restart, but Bullington not giving anything up. As they go into turns one and two side by side, McMahon's going to slide up and take second position on his own. Bullington now with Kyle Manis underneath him as Clyde Stanton and Warren McMahon put a little space between them. Bullington holding on to third. Kyle Manis not ready to send it yet. Doesn't have any sort of momentum. And there we go. 1-2-3, Stanton, McMahon, and Bullington. Joe Bray definitely a little bit loose and having problems controlling the car, so possibly some sort of suspension or maybe something wrong with the J-bar in that 76, maybe what caused him to spin there on that last restart. He's definitely not running as good as he was when he was at the front of the field, though. Clyde Stanton with about a half a straightaway lead over Warren McMahon. Bullington starting to close up on McMahon and put some distance between him and Kyle Manis, though. As we are lap 13 of 20 now. And Bullington definitely closing the gap on McMahon and putting a little space between him and Manis. Manis gets really loose in turn two. Clyde Stanton just in cruise control now with pretty open air in front of him. He will have the 28 car of Richard Cox to deal with here eventually. But right now he's just hitting his marks and turning some laps. The rest of the field pretty spread out behind him. Five laps to go being shown on the flag stand. And Clyde Stanton making quick work of Richard Cox for the lap. See if lap traffic holds up McMahon any for Bullington to make a move, but now Kyle Stanis is back there with Bullington, maybe making something interesting here in these final four laps. Two to go. Stanton, McMahon, Bullington, Manis, your top four. Kyle Manis starting to really look on the inside of Bullington now. As they come and see the white flag, one more lap. See if Manis has anything. Bullington's going to ride the high momentum. Manis tried to come on the inside and didn't quite make it stick. But here we go, last turn effort. Manis going to send it down, going to try to dig it, but will not hold it off. And Bullington will hold on to third. So that will be Clyde Stanton, your feature winner of Sportsman Late Model. Warren McMahon with a second place finish. David Bullington third, Kyle Manis fourth.